In today's video, I'm gonna tell you all about my new favorite tool for my resin 3D printers, and it's something you've probably never heard of or considered to use in this way, because it isn't something specifically made for resin 3D printers. I'll tell you more right after the break. Hi there, I'm Danny, the 3D Printing DM, and welcome to 3D Printed Tabletop, a channel where we cover all things 3D printing for your tabletop games. I'm talking about this peristaltic pump, and I want to tell you why and how it's made my resin 3D printing life easier, and why it still isn't a perfect solution to all of my resin woes. Now, for those of you who may not be familiar with resin 3D printers, if you want to take the resin out of your vat, then you need to unscrew the vat and pour it into some kind of container. Usually it's an empty bottle. Some folks might use a clean container like a red solo cup or other plastic container. A lot of folks will filter the resin in case there is any bits of cured resin in the vat. And when you're ready, you pour that filtered resin or maybe a different resin back into the vat or into a bottle if you want to store it. Now what these pumps allow you to do is to empty out your resin vat without needing to do any kind of pouring. You can even leave the vat on your printer without unscrewing it if you wanted to. Now the idea to try this pump out came from Grant over at 3D Musketeers on Twitter and here on YouTube, and it worked, hence this video. So thanks for the suggestion, Grant. I've been using this pump for several months now, and I've found that using it almost always is cleaner, it's easier to deal with, less waste involved, less paper towels and cloth, and there's less chance of messing up the FEP sheet because it touches things less, especially if it stays on the printer. Now the biggest trade-off is that it's a much slower process, which might bother some people. Now I'm sure some of you with resin printers are asking, why can't I just keep pouring out the vat into a funnel like normal? And you absolutely can. I still do in many cases, right? It's not like this is the perfect solution or answer, but there are a lot of situations when the pump is a viable alternative. If you're like me and you try different resins often, or you use different colors because of sales and so on, and you don't want to use up all your resin before swapping, it's a game changer for me, because instead of needing to pour it into a bottle, deal with cleanup every single time, I could do this without even removing the vat. You can also use these pumps to help you with cleaning. If there's any small bits of resin floating around from failure, suctioning them up is a great way for you to filter them out to make sure it doesn't get mixed. Now, there's a quick tip from Uncle Jesse that he made a few months ago, and using this, it's better and faster in my opinion, even if it's a little bit messier. So in the cleaning area, it's good, but it's not as good as the next one, which is the large format resin printers. Probably the real reason I felt pain for this and why it became a really valuable solution for me was with larger format resin printers. And that's everything from printers like the Elegoo Saturn, Anycubic Mono X, Frozen Sonic Mighty, to even larger resin printers like, you know, Piopoli Phenom. I ended up using these with the most mid-sized resin printers the most in terms of this pump, right? Now with the smaller printers, the build plate, the vat, they're way more manageable to pour. But once you start getting the larger vats, it becomes easier to spill. There's more table space you need. Amount of fiber cloth, paper towels, it just all goes up by a lot in my case because I'm very messy. This is an even worse problem with printers like this one, which is the Piopoli Phenom. For reference, this is the vat. This is a vat that we've been looking at most of today. And yes, those little things are failures that I haven't removed from the vat because of the exact reasons that I'm mentioning in this video. It's a pain in the So in the cases where I don't have to remove the vat, it's just so nice being able to use these when working with larger resin printers, especially for the failures that I can remove without even needing to take out the vat. The Uncle Jesse tip works here too with the bigger printers, but the amount of resin you waste also goes up significantly when you're burning that entire layer. Now, I also realized that these pumps came in handy when I was working with multiple printers, and I understand that's not common with everybody, right? But if you have a wash and curing station in one part of your workspace, transferring build plates and vats, you're more likely to get resin everywhere. It's a pain. And anything I can do to reduce resin getting everywhere, it's a win for me, and it's absolutely worth considering. That's why I have these mats. I bought these mats because my other table is disgusting. And that's real talk. All right, let's talk about cost. I feel these pumps are really affordable right now on Amazon. The pump and the tubing is $33. I tried a $78 one It's right here. This was the first one I bought. It's just a little bit faster. Not worth it in my opinion, but for the curious folks watching. I do have affiliate links down below if you're interested in purchasing one of these for yourself, but I did want to say a couple more things first. If you're worried about the FVP getting bent or scratched from the suction, don't worry because the suction's not strong enough to scratch the FVP, but it is still strong enough to suck up the resin. Now, I also cut the tip, the tubing at an angle because, you know, it would prevent that, and also it could make it go a little bit faster if I had it in a certain specific spot. I would also push the spatula to the side so that I could have more resin for it to suction if it was flat and I couldn't angle it. Now, I do recommend you keep an eye on these because if you just let them sit in an area where they fall, just like one little bend and they'll just go and you get like fire hose situation and it defeats the purpose of less mess. I'll probably have to make like a jig or something to hold these in place so I don't have to sit here for a few minutes holding it. But I just haven't had time to do that yet. Maybe the internet will provide, but that's the case right now. And when I'm done using these, I run some IPA through them into a spare container and then I'll cap them with a screw or something so that any spare resin doesn't leak out while I'm moving it around or storing it. And I also recommend using PPE because even though there's a lot of mess, there's still stickiness, which is inevitable when you're working with resin. And for those curious, it takes me about 5 to 7 minutes to completely suction out a filled vat on a standard small sized printer like the Mars or the Photon or the Mini. And it takes about 7 to 10 minutes to completely suction out a filled vat on the standard mid-sized printers like the ones I mentioned previously. So what do you think? If you have a suggestion for something better, you want to add anything, I would love to hear it. So please leave a comment. If you enjoyed this video, please click that like button and subscribe for more video goodness. It really helps the channel out a lot. And if you want to support the channel at no monetary cost to you, you can purchase any products using the affiliate links below. You can also pick up a late pledge and some sweet printable models on our website, lostventures.co, and you can support us over on Patreon as well. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Happy printing, and happy gaming.